Looks like you boys had some trouble.
Yeah, we had some trouble. Bad trouble. What you want?
Oh, I was supposed to meet some business partners here. They arranged a meeting, I believe.
Fellow with a scar and a Mexican?
Yes, sir.
Out by the stables, I think.
Thank you. And, sorry for your trouble, friend.
You don't know me. You turn up in town, you're helping everybody. And there's troubles everywhere. Bandits attack my fields.
And have you met my partner, Arthur Morgan?
No.
I met your son, the sheriff.
Okay.
Mr. Gray here was saying how he had problems with a family. A family of degenerates.
Oh, well, nobody likes degenerates.
Bad and inbred sons. They ruined this county. They killed my uncle, you know.
That ain't right.
Problem is, we can't be seen to get too close.
And?
We've got gold, Yankee. We've got gold.
I ain't no Yankee, friend. I ain't nothing. My daddy came over on the boat from Scotland.
I'm Scottish.
And the Braithwaites?
Goddamn pisses! I don't know. Mongols! Slave fuckers! All you gotta do is look at them.
How much gold?
Enough. These are prized horses I'm talking about. Them don't get you. 5,000.
5,000? For horses?
Easy.
And where do we sell them, these $5,000 horses?
Over in Clemens Cove. Fell over there, we'll run them out of state and give you 50 cents on the dollar.
Mister, you got yourself a deal.
Just keep us away from this. Publicly, I mean.
My sense is we keep all horse wrestling away from the public.
Go to the stables on the south side of the manor. That's where they keep the thoroughbreds.
Relax.
Coming through.
Okay.
Crazy old fool.
If he only knew, we just torched his tobacco crop.
That was you?
The old man was cursing the Braithwaites about that.
Burning rich folks' property? Sean was like a pig in shit.
I'm sure. 5,000 for horses. They must be rich.
Yeah, he doesn't know what he's talking about. But get any third of that, it'll be worth it.
Conrad,
so how are we gonna play this?
Place is well guarded, so there ain't no point in blasting in there. We'll make them think we're there looking to purchase.
Three armed men?
You'd be armed if you were about to spend 5,000 on horses. We should go in the back way, you know. Avoid too many questions. Careful. There's a guard.
I'll speak to him, okay?
All right, then.
Can I help you, gentlemen?
Yeah, we're here to see about some horses.
Horses?
Yeah, we had an appointment with Mr. Braithwaite, I believe.
Yeah, I never heard of him.
A partner wanted to make a significant investment in some stables down here. But perhaps we should look elsewhere.
Well, okay then. Head on up to the stable. Someone will come see you.
That's the stable just up ahead. Heads down, play cool. Head around the front, hitch up there. All right, let's hitch up here. Let me be talking. Okay, girl. Hello there.
Can I help you, boys?
I hope so. Heard you got some horses.
We always got horses.
Fine horses, I mean.
I don't get you, friend.
Yeah, you do. Come on.
Listen, why don't you get out of here? You, Scarface, and your greaser buddy.
Whoa!
I don't like officials.
We ain't officials. We're connoisseurs. Looking to do some breeding. Come on now, partner.
Okay, fine. Follow me. These here's mainly the studs available for purchase or for working. If that's what you're interested in. What is your boys interested in?
We represent a famous stable and stud farm from Saratoga.
Is that so?
Unofficially.
Of course. This here's Cerberus. Here you go, boy. Cerberus is a real reliable. Fathered many a race.
Greaser, huh?
Okay. Bandana's on. Don't need nobody recognizing us.
All right, I'll grab the white one in the middle. You get the other two. Nice boy. Come on.
Good boy. Easy now.
Marshmust, you're going to tether him up to... Marshmust, you're going to tether him up to Javier's horse.
Okay.
Javier, you're going to lead the stallions. Marston, you ride point. I'll cover up the back. If there's any problems, regroup at Clemens Cove.
Okay. This here's Cerberus. Cerberus is a real reliable stud. Fathered many a race. Greaser, huh?
Okay. Bandana's on. Don't need nobody recognizing us.
All right, I'll grab the white one in the middle. You get the other two. Nice boy. Come on.
Good boy. Easy now.
Marshmush, you're going to tether him up to Javier's horse.
Okay.
Javier, you're going to lead the stallions. Easy. You're okay. Good boy.
This way. Come on.
Marston, you ride point. I'll cover up the back. If there's any problems, regroup at Clemens Cove.
Okay.
Watch it! Let's go! Shit! One of the stallions is loose!
Keep going!
I'll get him!
Let's get this over with.
Well, that could have gone smoother.
That'll be on my gravestone.
You think they look like they're paying 5,000 for horses?
Yes, we'll see.
What you boys want?
Heard you pay good prices for horses.
Oh, we'll buy more or less anything, Pop.
That's so?
Sure, Pop.
I'm Clay Davies.
That's my brother Clive. We're twins.
John.
Arthur.
Javier.
So what are you?
Cuban?
No.
I don't like Cubans.
That's so?
Maybe. Why, what do you care? You ain't Cuban.
Maybe I like Cubans.
Ooh, you're funny.
He's funny.
Ain't he funny, Clive?
Clive don't talk.
We're twins, but I was born first. He came out all yellow and black, but he's okay.
Sure.
Yeah, I know these horses.
They ain't yours. But I like you, and I'll give you 654.
I was told the moon is made of ladies' tears. Only it ain't true.
Not one little bit.
But I like you boys.
But I ain't got more than 700 on me. You want it? Or you want to ride them fellas into town? And maybe someone there.
We're going to need more than that.
I ain't got no money, Pop. Here, take it or leave it.
All right, you goddamn fool monster, ain't no one around here got five thousand dollars, boys.
But nice meeting you. See you boys again, I hope. Come on.
Yeah.
Close the gate, Clive.
Leave the yarn, but us, that gray family.
Imagine we were gonna be wonderfully rich. At the end, we felt like prize idiots.
Arthur!
All good?
Hey.
What are you doing?
Going fishing!
The river's around here?
Famous for the smallmouth bass.
Fella I met showed me a couple spots. You wanna join me?
I can't for you. You're far too good.
Come on, join me. Show you a couple of my tricks. There's a spot.
Not too far from here. I've been wanting to try out.
Glad you're so excited about this.
You will be too when you start pulling out. Let's get going.
Whoa!
Ain't got you.
Come on. The fish should be hungry for their breakfast.
I thought you said it wasn't far.
Too far to walk. Come on.
Since we went looking for John on the mountain, already seems long ago.
How you feel about everything?
Been a strange couple of months.
Hey, you know, I can't even return to my country because the price of my head is so big. This is nothing exactly new to me. And I'll always be loyal to Dutch. He sees the world the same as I do. If we have to fight, we fight. If we have to run, we'll run. If we must die, we'll die. But we'll stay free.
And Dutch, you don't feel like he's doing things a little differently now?
You saw what happened to that girl on the ferry.
No fight, good or bad, is one without blood. I know that better than most. I think too many people are focusing on Dutch when they should be looking at themselves. What they could have done better.
Maybe you're right.
We'll cut through to the right here.
Damn it!
Hey!
The other day, I rode down to the Lanahatchee River.
Caught some beautiful steelhead trout.
You mean the Lanahatchee River?
No. The Lanahatchee runs right near here.
Yeah, but it's pronounced Lanahatchee.
Why is everything in English said differently than it's written? To make us feel stupid?
Oh, you're asking the wrong feller.
Okay, stay down the hill here. Arriba!
Whoa!
What's wrong, brother? Okay, come on. Let's go try our luck. Pretty country.
Beautiful.
Come on.
Let's go see what's biting.
You take this spot, Arthur. I'm going to cast over to the right there, so we're not in each other's way. insects are more likely to be out. We're lucky. Got such nice weather. But rain can be good. Sometimes big fish think the raindrops are insects.
Well, I guess it's still relaxing, even if I don't catch anything.
Sort of like staring at the sky.
It's your bait, I think. Come use some of mine.
Oh, it's not the bait. It's me.
I've always been a fisherman.
Especially compared to you and Jose.
Just try some here. Crickets.
Thanks.
He's a fighter. Trick is, let him tire himself out. Look at that.
Well done.
I was thinking. You remember that stagecoach we held up in Nevada?
Yeah. It was a tip. Crooked lawman. Reno.
We opened the door and it's full of women and children. Rich. But women and children. So we let it go. And read in the newspaper that the O'Driscolls robbed and killed them all the next day, further down the trail.
Yeah.
You know, way back in the day, O'Driscoll and Dutch were sort of friends.
Well, not friends, but they had an understanding. Then Combs Mean Street got meaner. Dutch wanted to try to live a different way.
Look at that.
That's a good looking fish.
Well done.
Okay, let's try for another.
I've heard people talk about huge smallmouth in Lake Owenjila, west of Strawberry, over in Big Valley. You need a lure to catch one that big, though.
Don't rush it, Archie.
Another one might make a nice meal.
Keep you.
It's almost noon. Official stop.
Because of the bugs?
Yeah, they only feed in the morning and evening. When it's cool and the bugs are out. So maybe we try a few more and then head back.
Fine with me.
I'm gonna head back. You wanna join me, or you keep trying for these bastards?
I'll come.
Okay, let's go.
Arthur. What now? You sweating yet, Dutch?
Of course
I'm sweating.
We're in some disease-ridden swamp, dixie-whistling shithole. What's your lawn shit about these bounties? I'm not sweating as such, but maybe a little gentle perspiration.
Until we know more, ain't too much harm in wasting good liquor on sweating.
So?
I think you should pay Mr. Trelawney a visit and find out exactly what he knows and who he spoke to. Take Charles with you. Oh, the sight of the pair of you would make a statue sing out its secrets.
Okay.
Charles,
I need you for some business in town.
Come on.
Okay.
Dutch wants us to have a talk with Trelawney about these bounty hunters coming for us.
Hey, wait for me!
Is everything okay? What are we doing?
Where are you off to?
Just ride with me.
Come on.
So, where were we? Hoping he can tell us who they are or where they're coming from.
Okay. And you're deputies now.
Something like that.
Soon as we laid eyes on that fool of a sheriff who runs that town, I knew Dutch was gonna play him like a fiddle.
On the run from one bunch of lawmen, working for another. Interesting.
Hiding in plain sight, Dutch calls it.
So, spirits in the new camp, I mean, we got some space between us and them. Ain't seen no pickets for a while. There's this bounty hunter, of course, but Dutch don't seem too worried about it.
Can't believe they're still coming after us. We didn't even get away with the money.
Yeah, but they don't know that.
Trelawney. I've only met him a couple times, but he's a strange one.
Fear not. He's just a cockroach, fancy creatures. But he gets into nooks and crannies the rest of us can't. We just need to find him before he scurries off again.
Let's take a look. Someone got here first.
So it seems.
By the looks of things, it wasn't a social call.
Check the house.
This food barely touched.
Looks like you left in a hurry.
What do you think? You see anything there? Found anything?
So it seems.
By the looks of things, it wasn't a social call.
Check that house.
Bed's not made.
So he must have been here recently.
Big struggle.
Pretty recently, I'd say. Guess maybe 12 hours ago.
But nobody.
Not yet.
Thank you.
Good morning, Arthur.
Arthur.
What now? You sweating yet, Dutch?